ఏపీ ప్రత్యేక హోదాపై రాజ్యసభలో చర్చ జరుగుతోంది. హోదాపై బీజేపీ ఎంపీ జీవీఎల్ నరసింహారావు మాట్లాడుతున్నారు. లైవ్ చూద్దాం.
చౌదరి ప్లీజ్ చౌదరి సార్, నోబడీ అండ్ యు స్పోక్ అబ్స్ట్రక్టెడ్ ఫ్రమ్ దట్ సైడ్. దిస్ నాట్ ఫేర్ ఆన్ యువర్ పార్ట్, నాట్ ఈవెన్ వన్. దట్స్ వాట్ ఐ యామ్ సేయింగ్, దట్ ఈస్ ద బ్యూటీ ఆఫ్ డెమోక్రసీ. హియర్ అదర్స్ హియర్ అదర్స్ మిస్టర్ రావ్, గో అహెడ్ ప్లీజ్, డోంట్ లుక్ ఎట్ ది అదర్ సైడ్.
ఓకే సార్,
యూ మేక్ యువర్ పాయింట్, దట్స్ ఆల్.
Yes sir, so what it the
that is for the people to decide, na, not for these, but with the opposition people will say, sir, whatever you're saying, right? Nobody will say, na.
Sir, the only conclusion that one can get from the documents I discussed only is that there was a special assistance measure or a package given by central government which was welcomed by the state government, and that package is still in operation. The value right. of that package has been explained right. or rather calculated by the right. chief minister himself okay. and the package is on. So where is the need for special category status? Why are you still provoking people? Is this right. not highly politically immoral?
Right.
Immoral.
You have taken 20 minutes, sir. Please take note. Go ahead,
sir. So that was the first assurance given
truth
by the
is, truth is in black and white in red also,
sir. The second assurance that the then prime minister gave referred to tax incentives to industrial units in both in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana and to the backward districts, and I'm happy to tell you this was so. Come on, and I have the facts with me. Okay sir, the CBDT, Central Board of Direct Taxes, had issued a notification on 30th September 2016, and this notification, it said 7 districts of Andhra Pradesh will can avail tax incentives under the Income Tax Act. They have been given depreciation allowance, they have been given investment allowance, as is the case with backward districts in the country. This was the assurance given on the floor of the house, and this has been fulfilled way back in 2016.
Right.
Number two. Right. No, I have.
Then you don't answer him. No, please go ahead.
Sir, today, in fact, incidentally. Sir, incidentally, I asked a question on the same to the Honorable Finance Minister, and they replied to it. They in fact told me what is the extent of units which have availed this benefit. There are many units which have already right. availed. It's a part of this house record. So second promise fulfilled. Now I'll tell you, this is all, it's all.
Please.
No, so.
Please. So nobody asked you to fulfill anything. Fulfill your duty of being disciplined in the house, that's all.
When I began the speech, I said it's propaganda, and I am tearing them apart bit by bit, because these are promises that have been kept. These are promises under implementation. Sir, the third point.
Come on, go ahead. Don't look that sir, side.
Sorry,
look at
sorry.
The house.
Chairman, sir.
Only governments has to take action.
Chairman, sir, you see, the special category, all special category states do not necessarily have income tax incentives. This is known. And on the day the then Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister, gave the assurances on the floor of this house, I would like to bring to the attention of the House members, special category states of Jammu and Kashmir, Uttarakhand and Himachal Pradesh did not have the 100% income tax exemption for corporate sector.
Don't get into duel.
Okay. Sir, on that day, Uttarakhand, on that day, any, no, I'm saying from the, on the day of February 2014, neither Uttarakhand, nor Himachal Pradesh, nor Jammu and Kashmir, none of these states had income tax or excise exemption.
Please, sit down.
I have the document.
I have to think something else.
I have the gazette notifications.